Oh. Far for this level, crap, this world must be getting pretty respectable by now in its size. Must be pushing a couple of hundred meg. Here I am just walking through a biome that I have spent weeks in some other seeds looking for. Just gonna make a note of that. So if I ever do decide to play this seed as something else, then I can. But then I've lost the thrill of the exploration, and why not just turn creative mode on? You know, 3D paint the rest of the way. Oh, shut up, zombie. And we see daylight again. It's getting late in the day, too. I think. Yeah, it is. Hey, squid. Do we have any bones? No. Would have been cool to find some dogs and take them along with us. Something for Cookie Monster to talk to. Pretend he's not losing his sanity ever so slowly. Like free hard drive space as this recording goes on and on and on. I may just beat Kurt to the Farlands if we go for too much longer, bloody hell. Whoa! Whoops, not quite what I intended. Something else that's cool to do for an extra challenge is lava oceans. That basically means that any body of water becomes a body of lava. Just something that you can do when you create the game. I did one world like that. And it's amazing how much you appreciate water in a case like that. Oh, it's getting late. Let's see if we can get over this ridge. Well, thing. I don't really know what a ridge refers to geographically, actually. Probably a good thing I'm not a geographer or a geologist or anything else, geo. It's a little mound of rock that we can dig ourselves into for the night. Yep, we're safe there, that there, that there, and we'll sleep. We'll sleep. Yep, any day now, we will sleep. Anyway, we're looking pretty good. Our armor has taken a beating from something. Maybe just falling damage. Our vision should be obscured, just looking at how that helmet works. Nope, lag. Carrying on in the same direction as before. Again, just through outright probability, we have to find one eventually. The world is infinite. It's like saying that there's no other sentient life out there in the universe. It has to have happened somewhere else. That looked like... No. So much hope. Should have made this a hardcore, actually. Should have made it hardcore with a random world and just kind of kept starting a new one, make a series of, you know, cookies or bust. Game with the cross shape. That looks pretty innocuous there, but I've noticed every now and again just little crosses pop up in the game. I make nothing of it. It's nothing of any personal significance whatsoever. Just something that my little girl started pointing out to me. When in one world that we have on the laptop, just a random floating cross appeared. So we had some fun with it. We stuck a creeper head on there. Creeper head on there, lit it on fire. It left this big flaming cross with a creeper head floating in midair. We built a castle under it. It was good fun. The ensign has a good sense of humour. Otherwise, game-wise, after Oblivion, I'll probably give I'll space out the Bethesda games just like I space out the Doom games. Well, Plains, I wonder if there's another village. So in between, I'll probably go from Oblivion to Morrowind. Because logic. I'll probably go from Oblivion to Morrowind, spaced maybe with Icewind Dale in between. I'd really like to play Icewind Dale. I want to play Baldur's Gate, but that's a phenomenal undertaking, and I'd rather have a lot more experience under my belt before I tackle that. But Icewind Dale is a good, fun D&D game. And once I've finished the first of the Minecraft Let's Plays, I'll probably get Eye of the Beholder, get that done. Because I enjoy the dungeon crawlers a lot. I know that Oblivion is by far the most popular thing on my channel to date, but I do enjoy Legend of Grimrock, and I loved Black Crypt, and those are the games that I'm really enjoying the most. Even if finishing them is a bit like coming to the end of a great book. You don't know what to do with your life when you get to the end. Especially Black Crypt. I rant about it often, but the ending of that game was... the ending was fine, but just after the ending, when you find the +10 weapons of everything. When you no longer need them. That combined with the level that isn't anything because it's just looted graves. I get the point of having them there for atmosphere and backstory, etc. But the fact that they do nothing, you can't return these objects to them or anything like that, just seems so absurd. Let's go and quickly check up over here. Let it gen. Oh, let's get in a boat. Travel around the coast and see if there's anything around there. Nah, roof forest. Screw you, game. What about further that way? Is that roof forest as well, or is that... That's roof forest as well. Those are dark oaks. Let's do a lap around. Not hitting the squid. Now we've got Sandy Island. Yeah, that's a roof forest. I can see mushrooms. There's a desert there. Follow this around. That's more roof forest, I'll bet. Even though behind it, trees like that one really do look like jungle trees. Jungle oaks, I can't remember what they're called now. Jungle wood trees. Anyway, how long... No, I don't want to open the land. How long have we been going? Lordy, nearly 2 hours. Nearly 2 hours. And we haven't found anything different. Well, we found a couple of villages. We found an ocean monument. I reckon there'll be something else under here as well. Being a deep ocean. It's not to say that there has to be something under there, but I would just think... that there should be. Definitely nothing else there. And we are still... yeah, 9,000. I think the... most mushroom islands apparently are... from about 3,000 plus. But I've only ever found the one, and that was in Minor Apocalypse, something like that. And I just happened to spawn there. That was neat. First and only one, and there was stuff all left, of course, because everyone goes there, they troll, and then they leave. Now that's the kind of land formation that would have a jungle on it. But apparently not this time. And it's getting late again. But I am determined. We will get there. We will find an effing jungle. This monster will have his cookies. Yep. Note to self. Set up Winamp with music next time. If anyone out there knows where to find the Unreal soundtrack, by the way, without just ripping it from the game files, which is something I really would prefer to avoid. Oh. Come back here, come back here. Thank you. Where is it, where is it, where is it? Crap, we're gonna have to build a new one. Really isn't that big a deal, it's just time. Whoa! Nope. Fix part of that up. Oh, when we stopped for the next night, and we'll make our new boats. Hey, sheep. You are white, and you are fluffy, and you are sheep-flavored. Beyond that, I have no use for you at this point. We will get to this formation. No, we'll get to that formation so that I'm constantly feeling like I'm heading in that direction. Let's block ourselves in. Oh good, just made it. And we were going to make our boat. Make a couple there. Grab our torch and... Whoa. I don't know what that was. And we have a desert. The bunnies want some carrot. There you go, little guys. We have sheep, we have another tiger. You know what? We haven't spilled some blood for a while. Leave one survivor to tell the others of the terrible blue menace that came through one day, waving a sword around and taking its friends home for lunch. I don't know. Ah, oh, sunflowers, wishing I had enabled cheats. But we're not going to. We're going to do this legit. Otherwise, what is the point? What was that? No, nothing. Grasping at straws by taking the desert, but the first jungle I ever found was on the edge of a desert. The second one I found was a bayou of sorts. But the first one was kind of in a tropical climate. I can't help but wonder if there are, you know, tropics in Minecraft, or a general theme. You know, for example... Oh, 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 oh! Is that... I can't see mushrooms. I can't see mushrooms in there. I can see a mushroom in there. Oh. I was so excited, but wow. That is getting a screenshot before the rest of the world gens around it. If that's an isolated feature, that would have to be the... Oh, rain, finally. Would have to be the coolest landmark I have ever seen this game create. In fact, that's going to be the thumbnail for this, I reckon. It's just an innocuous lump of rock, but just the way it formed like that, I just think it's neat. I'm like Marge Simpson with a potato. And a fuck ton of roofed forest. I can't believe how excited I got when I found that. How lame. But we have a savanna, which is in keeping with my theory. To a limited extent. Oh crap. Watch what you're doing, Captain Planet. You don't want to fall to your death. You do not want to respawn back in that village. They will probably not take too kindly to your second appearance there. They are probably pissed at the fact that I, you know, was careless with my incendiary implements whilst I stayed there and, you know, enjoyed their hospitality. Ouch. Crunch. Ow, my Cookie Monster legs. Savannah continues around there. Again with the trippy landmass. Take some holiday snaps. That's not jungle there. Is it? No, they're acacia. The way they looked like that made them look perilously close to jungle trees. But they are not. They are imposters, goddammit. Imposters, I say. As the game pauses to load even more world. There's a definite climate shift though. We started in a colder climate and we've passed through now to this warmer one. I think we might just be onto something with a logical climate progression. We're not going to find a fucking ice biome in the middle of this. I mean, we could. Knowing me, we're going to find a mesa before we find a jungle. Hello, chickens. You're still delicious. Looks like the savannah extends quite a way in that direction, but we'll go and we'll see how it looks. Again, that tree on the hill gives me false hope. I thought it was going to rain. What happened to that? Yeah, that doesn't look jungly to me. That might. Oh no, that looks like a birch. Let's have a look. Can always head back. Head back around the edge of the drier biomes and see if we find anything. If I find a tomb or something, we are totally exploring the hell out of it. No, they're birch. That's a regular forest. Let that generate. It's a regular forest, but what is that there? It's an interesting tree. It's probably just a mega tree behind an acacia behind a birch. Oh, that's pretty much exactly what it was. Called it! As he wandered through the desert, feasting on carrots, the land in the distance started to play tricks on him, as he thought he was finally nearing the end of his long, weary challenge. Oh my god, it's more savannah. Yep, it is. It's more savannah. trouble here is we can't dig in with all this sand. So we do need to get through. That's a nice little spot to build in the middle of there. You could wall that off with, I don't know, glass on each side. Maybe develop it into a waterfall. Have in the inside, have a lava flow along the... Is it concave on the one that flows that way? On the interior surface. Here we go, we can dig in here. There we go. Another night. What day are we up to? We are up to day 10. Cookie Monster's getting tired of this shit. Cookie Monster has had 10 days of carrots. He wants a cookie. Whoa, death drop. More greener savanna out that way. Oh, and right there. Whoops. Crunch. There will be a bit of a pause, I suppose, when we have to cook meat. Pardon me. I guess when it comes to that, I'll do that and then I'll scout around and see if any direction looks more promising than the other. But for the time being, we're just going to keep on keeping on. Or we can strike water. You know, that's good too. I see a village. So that's where we're going to head. Top up our carrots. I think we'll head over to the village, start our meat cooking, and from there we will, while our meat cooks, we'll have a look around. Unless... Nope, that's a forest. It was worth a shot, folks. Hello. You have ender pearls. I want your ender pearls. Anything to save my weary legs a few more steps. Two of you. Come back, you gutless mothers. I don't know. Something else we need to cook is our potatoes. Is there a blacksmith in here? Something with a couple of spare furnaces? It's a cool church. We don't need the books. Yes, that's what I wanted. We'll throw ours on there as well. What we'll do is... dig that, put that in there. Like this. That in there. Like that. And then those in there, like that. Grab that back. And while we're here, grab the iron, a saddle! Yes! Oh, that is a result right there, guys. Apples, because why not? Food. Now all we need to do is travel back, what is it, 15,000 tiles and find horses. But while our things are cooking, I don't want to go too far because I don't want this trunk to unload and for me to lose the lava bucket bonus, so to speak. Just to get up here and just see if anything does look more promising from a distance. I'll even crank the view right up. Options, video. The 25 appears to be the limit. 32 chunks. Come on, Duchess, let's see what you've got. I have never turned this game up that high. But let's give it a moment to load. So we've got plenty of savanna. Hills that way. You can see the... Oh, what if it unloaded the chunks to reload them and I've just fucked myself anyway? Probably has. Well, it doesn't look like any direction is any more promising than any other, really. And performance is sucking. So we're going to go back to... Not language. Oh my god. Options, video. Yeah, it is. It's turning itself back down. So we'll go back to 24. And I think at this point as well, I am going to be pushing the bounds of my hard drive too, so this seems a good spot to take a quick break, render that footage, and then I will be right back, because I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this all at once. We're going to set back up here. Have I lost? Oh, I didn't lose it. Okay, brilliant. Because 2 hours plus the 90 minutes of Oblivion that I have would think, be nudging my full hard drive. What do we got here? That looks like reforest because the world sucks. Oh yeah, pigs. Pigs like carrots. There you go, guys. Lots of little woobers. Roof forest, as far as the eye can fucking see. That great seed I was raving on about before, the one where I started in a taiga, I spent months searching for a roof forest. Problem with that was I was playing on my laptop and the view distance was set to, I think, 4 chunks. It was absolutely appalling. I could see from here to that village away. And here it's just trolling me. How are things going? Slowly but surely. Look, we have to wait around here for these to finish, so I will stop it recording while that happens. Because you don't need to sit here and... Well, there you go. You don't need to sit here while that happens, and I'll start it up again. I'm not going to move from this spot unless not... Here. Oh. Here. Won't move from this spot. Okay. And I will see you all momentarily.